Hello, and welcome to the next installment in NGM Map training videos. In this video, we will describe and show you the way to do encumbrance and encounter for a consumer within your agency. Now, I have already logged into the system, but you use your usual process to log into the system, and let's search for the consumer. Now, since the consumer has already been admitted, as we've shown in our previous videos, we will select a active status, click search, and search for the consumer that we have added. Let's put in the first name. Here we go. Here's the consumer we had admitted before. We'll click the select button. If you recall, this is the consumer with acute partial hospitalization. To get to the encumbrance module, we can either click next here or select the consumer from current admissions. So let's click here, next. Okay. Now we're in encumbrance module. The encumbrance module will allow you to change the units per month for a selected consumer. The reason you would want to do that is if, for example, as in this case, when the consumer was admitted, we originally selected 6 units of acute partial hospitalization per month. However, in some months you may need more, in other months you may need less. So this particular module lets you edit the number of units for this specific month, in other words, for April. So we can click Edit button, and let's change this to 8. Now, upon changing this, once we save this change, you will see the implication is reflected in net encumbered dollars and the remaining amount dollars. Since we went up for the specific units per month, and like I stress again, it is only for this current month. Please note the net encumbered dollars and the remaining amount. The remaining amount will go down, and the net encumbered dollars, because you're encumbering more units in the specific month, will go up. So let's take a look. Here we go. Number went up, remaining amount went down. And now we have 8 units per month. We can also subtract units. So let's say for this month we only need 5. The amount is reflected here. It's units times unit cost. Again, we click Save. The remaining amount went up, and then encumbered went down. The next section of the process, and the next step in the process, is encounter. This is where you're actual billing for these units, for the units that you, a service that you provided to the consumer, actually takes place. So let's click the next button, or you can click encounter billing here. So for, as we said, for the month of April, there are 5 monthly units that have been allocated. There are none that have been encountered as of yet, so therefore there are 5 remaining. We can click on, click here under the encounter in order to encounter or bill for those units. As you notice, upon clicking the encounter, we have a a partial view of the calendar, and the calendar is view for acute partial hospitalization for the month of April. Only the units that are their days that are allowed to be billed for are shown here. So let's enter 2 units here and 1 unit here. We also have to, in order to save this information, we have to agree to very specific text down here. So by checking this box, the NGMF user entering the encounter information is confirming that such encounter data has been encountered accurately based on information recorded in the client's progress note on the entered date with respect to the type of and duration number of units provided to the client. And the second second agreement here is to check the box to the left if the service identified in the encounter billing calendar is not a Medicaid-covered service, or you have checked the EMV emails and confirmed that the consumer receiving the service was not eligible for the Medicaid on the dates for which you entered the U.S. Obviously, Medicaid is the first payer before the state, so we're going to check this dialog box and click Save. I'll tell you this much. Upon clicking Save, you will notice that the billed units or encountered units will go up, the amount for those units. So let's click Save here. Now, as you notice, encounters billed has gone up. And the record is successfully added. In phase two, we have added another feature to this module, into this functionality, where upon encountering, you realize that, you know what, I should have encountered three of them. You can't change it by just clicking an encounter because those encounters have already been done. But what we can do is, let's close out of here, we can void this encounter. Please note that this void availability is only there until the end of the billing cycle. Once the billing is run, in other words, the checks are cut, you can no longer void this particular encounter. So let's click Void. It'll show you which units and service dates and number of units were encountered. We'll click Void here. And as you can see again, encounter cumulative is 0, monthly units is 5, remaining is 5. Okay. Next section here is discharge. So let's click on next. Please note that once you discharge the consumer, you will no longer be able to bill through NGMF for that consumer. So make sure all your billing is done prior to discharge. So we'll put a discharge date as today's date. We have to select one of the discharge reason codes. So let's select this one. And any comments. The comments are not required, but are encouraged to enter to be entered simply for historical purposes. So you can remind yourself of why. I'll just put in test. Click Save. The confirmation dialog box comes up. You click OK. And the consumer has been successfully discharged. To validate that, we can go to the home page, select All Inactive. And here's our consumer, and the status is now discharged. This concludes the consumer process in NGMAP. The next video will be in regard to the user administration part of the system and will only be relevant to the provider administrators within your agency that are tasked with the setup and password reset and user information change for your agency. Thank you very much and have a nice day.